Welcome, my dear students, for the session number 32. Yes, in this session, we are going to deal with the topic process states, in that orphan process and also the zombie process, and also we will know about how the running jobs in background, nice values to give nice values, killing the process with the signals. We will deal with all these things. Okay, so before that, a small recap of the previous session, that we have seen the internal and external commands in a shell's point of view, and also the process states, where in two types, in two pictorial diagrams, we have just depicted the states of the process, how it will be when it is created and how it will be when at your running time. Okay, so by recalling that thing, those process states, we will move on to our today's session. So here, at any instant of time, a process is in a particular state. You can tell, see, any instant of time means, if I am placed, means our process is in zombie, running, interruptible or uninterruptible. You can tell, any instant of state will be the status of your particular process. Once the process is created, means that will be in a runnable state. Before it is on a run, that is state of running. Running and runnable, both are shown in one pictorial, okay. So here, actually both are two different, but it is denoted as R in our Unix operating system, okay. So here, runnable, first when it is created, it is in runnable and it is ready to run. So run means it is waiting for your CPU time. While the process is running, when the process is at a running state, on that time, if it may be invoke a disk operation, if at all, if any disk operation is nothing to do expect, what it should do, it will go to the wait. Wait, that in waiting also, you have a two states, like one is uninterruptible sleep and the another is interruptible sleep. So if you are doing some job, if any other external signal can invoke this one, means that is interruptible. If nothing can be done until and unless its job is finished, means that will be your uninterruptible. So wait will be inevitable until and unless your IO completes. The process then moves from your sleeping state to your woken. Like it will wakes up. When means when its job is finished. So when IO, it is went for a IO operation, means if the IO operation is completed, then it is woken and it will comes back to your running. So when it is running, means on that time, even you can suspend the process by pressing the Control Z button. See, process whose parents, see here, the process whose parents don't wait for their death. Parents who are not waiting for their death means that will move to the zombie state, where the child process will just move on to the zombie state and it is keep on waiting until and unless it reports to its parent process. So this is what is happening inside our operating system. Okay. So what is this zombie or orphan processes? We will just see. A process which has finished its execution but still has an entry in the process table in order to report those details to its parent process is known as zombie process. A child process always first becomes a zombie before being removed from the process table. So from the process table, if it has to be removed, means then first and foremost it has to report its parent process. Okay, the parent process, as soon as it knows that, like, oh, this zombie one process is waiting at a zombie state, means that parent process will read the exit status of the child process, which reaps to the child process entry from the process table. So it will just remove the entry from the process table as soon as it takes the status of the child. So when a process dies, when the process dies, it is immediately moves to a zombie state. So whenever the process dies means it is moved to a zombie state. It remains in this state until the parent picks up the child state, exit status. So that's what we are telling. Until and unless it receives the child status. So for that is the main reason for waiting those process in a process table. So when that is one, the kernel frees the process. When it is done with the job means what it will do, the kernel will freeze the process table entry. So I can tell you, a zombie is a harmless dead child, but you can't kill it. It is also possible for the parent itself to die before the child dies. There is a possibility where parent will die before this child will die, isn't it? It might feel like child is waiting at the zombie, but the parent itself is dead means on that scenario the child becomes orphan. What it is? The child becomes orphan. So on that time our kernel is the one where makes the INIT process to adopt all the orphans, where this will adopt that child in order to wait for its death. See here, orphan process means what? A process whose parent process no more exists, that is either finished or terminated without waiting for its child process to terminate, is called as an orphan process. It's very simple. So what we are telling, if parent is dead means automatically the child process will become an orphan process. If that's so means, as we all know, the mother of the all process is INIT. So that process will adopt that child before it dies. Okay. So coming on to the next topic, that is running jobs in background. In the previous session, we were talking there are a background session process which is running. So yes, so we are knowing, like we know that many process or many jobs are running at the background. So how to get it, how to know it? So that is where we are going to learn about more about this. A multitasking system lets render do more than one job at a time. So here your multitasking system will allows your user to do more job at a given time. So there can only be one job in the foreground, the rest will be at your background. Of course, there is only one desktop, so on that you can see only one application. Even though you have multiple application open on your desktop, still you can see only one with a view, isn't it? So that's what, and there are two ways of doing this with the shells. So here you can make this background to be viewed. So in the two ways, that is by using a ampersand operator and no hub command. So these are the two ways where we can make our foreground to go back, that is background. So ampersand, that is no logging out. So what is this? We are not logging out from the terminal, instead we are in that, but we will be running background. If we are doing that, this ampersand is the shell operator which is used to run the process in the background. The parent in this case does not wait for the child's death. So what it will do? It is not at all going to wait for the child's death, the parent. Okay. Just terminate the command line with an ampersand. The command will run in the background. For example, see here what we have given. Sort command. So minus O option we have given. So emp list and this we have given the file names and with an ampersand. If we press an ampersand and we press an enter key, automatically we will get a jobs PID. That is, what is the process ID of this job? That is 550. Okay. So now what it will do? The shell immediately returns the number, that is the PID which is invoked by this command, that is 550 will be invoked, and the prompt is returned and shell is ready to accept another command, even though the previous command is not at all terminated. Still it is ready to accept a new command. Why? Because this statement has been pushed to background. Okay, the shell, okay, it remains the parent of the background process. Using an ampersand, you can run as many as jobs you want at your background as the system load permits. Remember, so as your system load is permitting, that much you can go for a background. If you are putting more and more, means of course your system will be in a hang up mode. Okay, so background execution of a job is usually featured that it utilizes a really good time consuming or low priority jobs to the background. So you are just running the important ones in the foreground. You make sure that you are running the important ones on the foreground, and the rest you are just pushing up into a background by using this ampersand at the end of your command line. Okay, so this is the story of your logging, story of your ampersand operator. Next, coming on to our no-hop, means what? It's nothing but no hang up. So we don't want our system to get hanged, isn't it? So whenever we like every command, whatever the command which is in your Unix, will start its own process at the time of its execution, isn't it? So on that time, automatically it gets terminated upon exiting the terminal. Just remember, as soon as you are quitting out from your function, what it will do? It will exit from the terminal automatically. Suppose you are executing program over your shell, one of the shell, and the connection is getting dropped. Means you are not getting the connection to your shell. On that time, the sessions will be terminated and all your process will be stopped, isn't it? And you may face a huge accidental crisis. So this is what, like, you will be in an accidental position. So in order, in such cases, if you want your running commands in the background can be helpful means to the user, this is where you can rely on. That is, no-hop command comes into the picture. Here what we are doing, instead like getting into our previous, we are just handling, everything will be handled properly by using the no-hop command. Okay, so what is this no-hop command? It is a Unix systems command that runs the process even after logging out from the shell or terminal. So even though you have logged out from your terminal, your process will be keeps on running until and unless it is completed. So usually every process in your Unix process, Unix operating system, you will be sending one, that operating system will send sig up. See here, no hop command prevents the process from sig up is the one which will be sent. So what is this sig up means? It is a signal hang up, SIG signal hang up, which is responsible for terminating the process after closing or exiting the terminal. This scenario you might have seen while you are shutting down your Windows, but still it displays some programs are running. Do you want to forcibly shut down the system? It will ask. Have you faced these problems? Yes, of course, many have faced this one, isn't it? Yes. So, it will ask for, it will give the prompt saying that, already these much of a task is running, still do you want to shut it down? It will ask. Yes means automatically the terminate signal, that is the sig up signal, will be given out, and it will make everything, every task to be closed. So, no-hop command prevents the process. When you have given a no-hop command means, what is the action of this? Even though you have shut down or you have left the terminal, still your process should run. If signal hop comes into picture, means automatically every process will be logged out, isn't it? So that's why when you are no-hop command you have given along with your no-hop command, means it will prevent the process from receiving the sig hang up. Okay, so what it will do? It will prevent while just receiving this signal upon closing or exiting the terminal. Okay, so once your job is started or executed using the no-hop command, stdin, That is, one more library will not be available to the user. Okay, when you have executed with nohook command, means your stdin will not be available to the user. So what it should do, and nohook.file is used as the default file for your standard output and standard errors. For these two, you should use what? Nohook.out file. Okay, in summary, I can tell that if you are using nohook command, which allows your process to run even you have terminated, okay, and if you have terminated, means what this nohook command will do, means it will avoid this sighup command so that it can run without any problem. And on that case, the stdin, which is not at all available to the user, and it provides its own nohook.out file, where it is the default which is used for your standard output and also for your error things. Okay, if the output of the nohook command is redirected to some other file, means then nohook.out file is not generated. Make sure that should be generated, or else you might land it into a problem. Okay, so that you must take care of it. You must use and with all lick. So this is our syntax, nohook command, command argument. So you can go for an example. See here, nohook is our command, sort is the command which has been given out, and this is our argument saying one file we have given with an ampersand. So what it is said, this is your jobs PID, process ID, which is sending output where nohook.out. So the nohook, that is no hangup command, when it is prefixed to a command, so what it is doing? Yes, it permits the execution of the process. Whatever the sort process which is asked for, it will permit even you have logged out. The shell will return its PID. This PID is returned, and somehow shell will display the message as well when nohook command is run in these shells. So nohook sends the standard output. Whatever this output which has been received from this command will be sent out onto the file, that is nohook.out file. Okay, so this is what is the action which will be done by your nohook command. So when you use the ps command after using the nohook from another terminal, see, we have taken two terminals. In one terminal, we have used the PS, but when after using the nohook from other terminal, in the second terminal, we have already given nohook. Okay, in the another terminal, we have pressed PS. So what you will see, this is what is the significant, you will find it out. See here, PS minus F minus U Kumar. So here, look what's happened in this time. Here, the shell is died, isn't it? So the shell has been died. So rather was killed. Actually, it has been killed. Why? Because from the another terminal you have set nohook. So on logging out, but it's child, that is sort. Whatever the sort is there, it is a child. So in the previous what we did, sort command we have run, right? So the sort, that is the child, still it is doing its action, and it turned into an orphan. So it has been orphaned, so that's why its parent PID is 1. You can see now. See here, it has been turned into orphan. The kernel, what the our kernel will do, the kernel will handle such situation by raising the PPID, that is the parent of this PID. What we told, mother of all processes, our INIT process. And this INIT process has its PID 1. So the parent PID will be turned into 1, where when the user logs out, the INIT will take over the percentage of any process run with the nohook. In this way, where you can kill a parent, that is the shell. The shell was their parent, right? You have killed a parent without killing its child. See, the child is still existed, but you have killed the shell which has been created. Okay, if you run more than one command in a pipeline, you should use the nohop command at the beginning of each command in the pipeline. There are chances like you can give a multiple commands on a single line. You can combine the two or more commands by using a pipeline, isn't it? And when you want to use the more than two commands, means by using a nohop, then each and every time before you have to prefix nohop command to your commands. See here, grep is one command which we have given, so nohop. And also sort is another command, nohop. And also remember to terminate the command or the process by using ampersand. See here, so ampersands. So this is how we will work for a multiple commands to be given out in a one single line using pipeline. The next concept is nice, that is job execution with low priority. So nice command in our Unix helps in execution for the program and process, and also each process needs to it has been modified scheduling property. So it has a capacity to modify its scheduling priorities. Okay, it launches a process with its user defined scheduling priority. So whenever the process is launched, means if a user has defined its priority, then that is given out. In this, if we give a process a higher priority, then the kernel will allocate the CPU time so that the process can run. And here you can see your nice command in Unix helps in execution of the process with a modified scheduling priority. So here you can give, it's running the instance of programs means what? You are giving some RAM space and CPU time for each and every process in order to execute it. So that's what we are doing over here. Okay, the nice command will start its specified nice values. Okay, the renice command means what? The renice command will allows you to change and modify the scheduling property of an already running process. It is already running, but still you can change the priority by using renice. Okay, and so here one more thing, the running instance of program is a process, and each process needs the space in RAM. It needs a space in RAM and CPU time to be executed. So each process has its priority in which it is executed. Okay, one important thing you have to notice, that here the nice value which you are giving, it will only control your CPU time assigned to a process and not your utilization of your memory or IO devices. You are not touching with the resources like your memory, IO devices. Only you are talking about the CPU time which has been assigned. Okay, so here one nice command is used in order to start the process with a specified value. Okay, so whereas renice command is used in order to alter your running of process. So process usually in Unix system, it will be usually executed with the equal priority. So equal priority kodirudhe in Unix operating system, always the each and every process will be allocated with equal priority. If it is not always if the higher priority jobs comes, means it has to be completed first. So Unix offers the nice command which is used in order to, with an ampersand operator, to reduce the priority of jobs. In order to reduce the priority of jobs, to run a job with a low priority. So what we are doing here, we are just giving a low priority for a job. We are making a job to run with a low priority. The command name should be prefixed with nice. So you can see the nice WC word count command which we have given with minus L UX manual, or you can even give it like nice with the ending with an ampersand operator. Okay, this nice is a built-in command. What is this? This nice is in a built-in command in the C shell, where its values are system dependent and it typically ranges from 1 to 19. These values ranges from 1 to 19, and the commands which are executing the nice value are generally in the middle of the range, that it might be like usually at 10 or 11 like that. Okay, a higher, whatever the higher the value, nice value which you are implying, so that will be the lowest priority. Higher the value, the lower the priority. Nice will always reduces the priority of any process, thereby raising its nice value. Nice, as soon as the nice values are increasing, means the priority of the process are decreasing. So you can also specify the nice value explicitly with minus n option by giving nice minus n 5wc minus L UX, where what it has done, its nice value increased by 5 units. Okay, so one more thing, this nice value can't be given by any non-privileged user. So you can't increase the priority of the process. Okay, that power is reserved only for the super user, and the nice value is displayed with PS minus O nice command. Okay, so this is what is the our nice value where rising up will gives us. Okay, next, kill, that is killing process with the signals. So the unique system will often request to communicate the occurrence of an event to a process. So here this is done by sending a signal to the process. So here each signal is identified by a number, and it is designated to perform the specific function. So what it is doing, each and every signal, here we are just sending a signal in order to stop the process, to kill the process. In order to do that one, it has been identified by a number and as well as with a specific functions where it can perform. Because here the same signal number may represent two different signals to two different machines. For that reason, signals are better represented by their symbolic names having the SIG prefix. Instead of having a identifying by a number, it is better to use a symbolic names by using a SIG prefix. If a program is running longer and you might feel like wow, what it is, and you want to terminate it, so normally what we will do, we will just terminate by your interrupt key. This will send the process with the signal INT, that is signal INT, interrupt signal, which is numbered 2. Okay, the default of the signal is to kill the process. So what you are doing, you are just stopping the process abnormally by sending the signal INT, that is the interrupt signal. A process may also ignore a signal or execute some user-defined code written to handle that signal. So that's what you have to take care, like whether this will be done or not. Okay, so here there are two signals that process can't ignore. The two signals which can't be ignored means they are the SIG kill and SIG stop signals, which always perform the default actions which is associated with them. So next, the kill command will send a signal, will usually with an intention of killing one or more process. So what this command will do, it will terminate the process. Okay, so here kill is an internal command, and in most of the shells it acts as a internal command. The external where it will be residing in the directory bin under kill, which is executed only when the shell lacks the kill capability. So kill ana command work agilla, when it is not working with the internal command, then the external command will take place and that will be used. Okay, the command uses one or more PIDs as its arguments and by default uses the SIG term 15. So, SIG term 15 signal. So, here, just check it out. Here, what we have done, we have given a kill command 105, where this 105 is nothing but the PID of a particular process. It's like using kill minus s term 105, which terminates the job having PID 105, where it, in order to facilitate premature termination, the ampersand operator displays the PID process which is running in the background. You have to remember that the PID which uses the PS to know that, then you use the kill command. Okay, so if you run more than one job either in the background, we can kill them all with a single kill statement. In a different windows also you can do this one. Just to specify their PIDs with the along with the kill command. Just see here, kill, and we have given n number of PIDs. So if all these process have the same parent, suppose it has the same parent, means instead of killing each and every child, what we can do is you can simply kill the parent in order to kill all the children. Okay. So, what over here, we have said most of the shells uses variable, that is $exclamatory, in order to store the PID of the last background job. The same number seen when the ampersand is affixed to the command. So, this is what we are doing over here, where sort minus OEMP with an argument list, we have given ampersand. Okay. So here 345. So it is running with the job number 345. And what I am doing is I will send a command which is kill dollar with an exclamatory. So what it will do, it will kill the sort command previously worked. So whatever which is last currently the command which has been executed, that will be killed. Okay, so you can kill the last background process without using the PS command. So how it is? By just giving the kill with an dollar and an exclamatory. Okay, now, so the kill command takes in a termination signal which you have one of the several values. You can see we have four types of values over here. SIG INIT 2, SIG kill 9, SIG quit 3, SIG term 15. So here, as soon as you say like SIG INIT 2, which has the same result of pressing Ctrl C in a terminal, so it does not automatically end the process. So SIG quit is the one which does just like your SIG INIT with the added benefit. What is the added benefit of this is it produces a core dump on your machine. So kill 9, which forces the termination of the process and it can't be ignored or gracefully shut down. You can't even shut down with graceful, you are just terminating. So SIG term 15, which terminates the process but gives time to gracefully shut it down. Okay, if you have not specified the terminal signal, the default signal term will be a 13, that will be used for termination. So this is how your kill will keeps on working like this, okay, using your kill. So with the other signal, so you are using kill along with the other signal. So here the kill command used with the signal name without the SIG preceded by the minus s option. So, without the SIG as a preceding, we can also delete it by using minus S option. Just look into this, kill minus S, kill 121. So, where you are recommending way of using kill. Actually, this is the proper pattern of killing a process. Next, kill minus 9, that is 121. It will just do the work whatever like the previous statement, that is the kill minus L kill 121, but it is actually not recommended to do like this. a simple command, a simple kill command with the term like won't kill the login shell. Still, you can kill your login shell by using any of these commands. Like actually, whatever the kill command which you are passing, it actually won't touch your login shell. But still, if you want your login shell to be dead, so on that time you can go for a kill minus 9, that dollar dollar. So where dollar dollar will stores the PID of a current shell. So current shell's PID is stored in this dollar dollar. If you give it by kill minus 9 dollar dollar, automatically your current shell will be dead. So kill minus s kill 0. So this is the where this command, after executing this command, all the process which is running on that shell, not only that but even your login shell also will be killed. So this is how your kill minus s kill 0 will work. Okay, so summing up today's session, that is, we have seen or we have learned about process dates, orphan process and zombie process, and also how this background process can be like retrieved or can be sent to a background. So everything we have just known, like by ampersand operator, nohop command, nice value, kill command. So we have seen all this in our today's session, and we have got a knowledge like how this like a process will be given with their priorities and how to make it as the highest or the lowest priority depending upon the system. Okay, so upon the user's choice also they can give the priorities, and these are all the references which we have referred, and you can refer it for your further information. So this is for our today's session. Thank you.